So I was driving home from work on a Friday in May, and I had worked until 4 o'clock and felt fine. And as I was driving home, I got a really sharp pain in front of my chest and then a really sharp pain in my back. And when the ambulance came, they thought I wasn't having a heart attack, but thought maybe I should go to the hospital anyway just to get checked out because the pain hadn't gotten any better. And so I went to Kingston General Hospital and Merge in the ambulance, and the doctor that was on call there, she listened to my heart and she thought I had a heart murmur. And she asked me if I had a heart murmur, and I said no, that I'd never had a heart murmur before. So she decided to do an ultrasound, and that's when she saw that there was something wrong.
What Mrs. Shaver suffered was called an aortic dissection. So an aortic dissection is when the major vessel from your heart is damaged and it can burst and can lead to sudden cardiac death in patients. What causes aortic dissection? Well, there are different reasons for the aorta, the major vessel coming from the heart, to be damaged. One of them could be the fact that the aorta is dilated, or the tissue might be weak. For example, this may be related to high blood pressure. So those are the reasons why it's very important for us to monitor patients if they have a dilated aorta, or if we know that they have causes that can lead to weakness of the aortic tissue. Some of the symptoms related to aortic dissection include chest pain. The problem is that chest pain can also be due to a run-of-the-mill heart attack. And so that's why it's a bit of a diagnostic dilemma when patients come into the emergency department. It's hard for doctors to figure out whether the chest pain is due to a heart attack, which is also a serious problem, or due to an aortic dissection. So one of the things we do to try to determine whether it's an aortic dissection or a heart attack is that we might do some emergency tests, such as a CAT scan that happened in Mrs. Shaver's case, or we may also do an ultrasound of the heart to directly look at the heart and directly look at the aorta to see which part of the cardiovascular system is being affected and causing the chest pain.
So the aorta was ruptured along its whole length, but the portion that was mostly at risk of complete rupture and subsequent bleeding was very close to the heart as well as to the neck vessel. These cases need to be treated on a very emergent basis. That means that she was required to treat it immediately. It was an overnight operation and it lasted several hours. It lasted 5 hours and a half. And unfortunately, the rupture of the aorta was so close to the origin from the heart that it also required the valve, it's called the aortic valve, to be replaced. So this operation, it's clearly a picture of how complex this condition can be. But when we're treating patients with an aortic dissection, first of all, we have tissues that are extremely frail, and even from the technical standpoint, suturing the prosthesis, the synthetic material, to the native aorta can be very complex. The risk of having bleeding, severe bleeding after surgery is extremely high.
My life is a bit different since the surgery. I'm required to take quite a few medications, and I'm probably for the rest of my life will be followed up by cardiologists to make sure that the valve is functioning properly.
These are changes that are obviously recommended for most heart conditions and are definitely important to be followed over time. However, there are some changes that are unfortunately related to the extensive surgery she had to undergo. And this is why we're hoping to detect this problem before it gets to this stage. And this is also why we're trying to understand if there are any issues that we are currently missing in the detection of the rupture. We are working very extensively here at Queens, along with the Department of Engineering, in order to understand if beyond the size of the aorta, which is the typical parameter we have been using to consider a patient at risk or not, if there are other factors in the property of the wall of the aorta that can lead us to consider a patient at higher risk and potentially requiring operation.
So right now we're in the process of developing a test device, a rig, that would allow us to characterize the structural properties of actual discarded aortic material. And by doing so, we'll have really details about how this material will expand under pressure, and with the eventual goal is to have a synthetic material that would allow us then in lab settings to study this in more complex environments as well. And so this is the interplay between engineering and medicine, where we have engineers and medical researchers together coming up with ways of studying these problems in parallel with each of the strengths of our respective measurement techniques. So the ultimate goal is to have a feedback loop with my colleagues in medicine, so that we can take the knowledge we're obtaining in our controlled lab-based measurements and provide the diagnostic tools for the clinicians, which will allow them to identify which patients are at risk and essentially prevent or better avoid dangerous circumstances for these patients.